Hello students, I hope you all are doing good. Today in this video we are going to see exercise of chapter 2 which we have seen in previous videos. So students, what you have to do, you have to make a new book, separate book of science subject. Start from a new page. Take a pointed pen, put the chapter's name on the top of the page and then start writing exercise. Okay, now what is here? Question number 1. These all questions are taken from your textbook. In case you are not understanding any question, refer your textbook or put it in front of your notebook and then write from it. What is here? Question number 1. Write the answers to the following question in your own words. What is A here? What are the differences between plants and animals? Plants or animals mein kya fark hai? Number 1. Plants make their own food. Animals cannot make their own food. Plants apna khana khud banate hai. Animals apna khana khud nahi bana sakte. Wo depend rehte hai. Now what is the second point? Plants cannot move from one place to another. Animals can move from one place to another. Plant apni jagah se nahi hil sakte, but animal can move. Now number 3rd point. Plant inhale carbon dioxide and exhale oxygen. Plant inhale carbon dioxide. प्लांट जो है वो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इनहेल करेंगे और ऑक्सीजन लिब्रेट करेंगे. एनिमल्स वाइज वर्स है, एनिमल्स का अपोजिट है. एनिमल्स ऑक्सीजन इनहेल करेंगे और कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एक्सहेल करेंगे. नंबर 4. प्लांट हैव क्लोरोफिल पिगमेंट. प्लांट्स हैव अ ग्रीन कलर पिगमेंट दैट इज क्लोरोफिल. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट पिगमेंट दे मेक देयर ओन फूड, हेंस दे आर ऑटोट्रॉपिक. तो what is the 4th point in the animals? Animals do not have chlorophyll pigment, hence they are heterotrophic, means hence they depend on another animal. Now what is B here? What are the similarities between plants and animals? Plants or animals ke beech ki kaun si same baatein hai? To one is plants and animals both are living things. They both are living things. They need air, water and food to live, to sustain their life. What do they need? They need air, water and food. Number 3, they both excrete waste substance. They store their waste substance and then they excrete, means process of excretion takes place in both plants as well as in animals. Number 4, they both reproduce as well as respire to survive, means here are two functions that they do. First is reproduction and second one is respiration. These two processes can be taken in plants and animals. Now what is the next question? How is the plant kingdom useful to us? How is this kingdom useful to us? How it is beneficial for us? So plants are helpful for us to sustain life. Obviously plants are helpful for us to sustain life because students, they liberate oxygen and that oxygen is taken by us, and we liberate carbon dioxide and that carbon dioxide is taken by them. Oxygen, here it is the same point. Okay, number 3, some plants are used as medicine. Some plants are used as medicine like tulsi and many more other plants. Number 4, plants are useful for household purposes like meetha neem, kadi patta, coriander. These are the plants that are useful for household work as well as for industrial purposes and for also industrial purposes. Now what is the next question here? How are the animal useful to us? How are animal useful to us? Now animals are very useful to us. Dog, cat, cow, buffalo are kept for domestic purposes. Why do we keep dogs in our house? Because they guard it. Why do we keep cows in our house? Because they gives us milk. Why do cats are seen in our house? Because they catches mice, right? Now what is the second point? Fish, sheep, beef are used as food. While animals like horses, oxen, camel prove useful in various occupation, they use for taking load from one place to another place for transportation, they used. Okay, now what is the 4th point? The earthworm is very useful in agriculture. Students, earthworm ko farmer ka friend kaha jata hai. Why? Because it moist the soil. Because it moist the soil. Hence, earthworm is very useful to in agriculture. Now, what is the next question? What makes living thing different from non-living thing? ऐसी कौन सी चीज़ें हैं, ऐसी कौन सी बातें हैं जो नॉन लिविंग थिंग और लिविंग थिंग को अलग बताती है? सिंपली यू हैव टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन दैम. ओके, तो लिविंग थिंग्स नीड एयर, वाटर एंड फूड फॉर देयर लाइफ. व्हाट डू लिविंग थिंग्स नीड? एयर, वाटर एंड फूड. दिस थ्री थिंग्स लिविंग थिंग नीड, बट नॉन लिविंग थिंग डू नॉट नीड दिस. Now second point is living things can move, non-living things cannot move. Now what is the third point? Living thing grows. Living thing have growth but non-living thing do not have growth. Living thing have ability to reproduce. Means the process of reproduction can be taken by living thing but non-living thing does not have that function. Okay, now what is the question number two here? What helps them to breathe? Here are some trees and plant is given. What you have to mention, you just have to mention a source from where they are breathing, from where they are breathing. Like a fish breath from gills, a crane breath from lungs, man from nose, a caterpillar from spiracles, a snake from lungs, an earth from skin, and banyan tree from leaves. Okay, student, what is the next question here? Fill in the blanks. I haven't written fill in the blanks here. You just have to write directly answers. Okay, what is the first answer? Photosynthesis. Now, second one is oxygen and then carbon dioxide. There you have to write two answers. Now, what is the third one? Responsiveness to stimuli. Now, move on to the next page. Question number five. In question number 5, what you have to mention? You have to mention precularities. What is precularities? Precularities means khasiyat. Aapko khasiyat batani hai in living things ki. So what is the precularity of kangaroo? It hops with hind legs. Means kangaroo have hind legs. Uske jo legs hote hai, wo chupe hue hote hai. And it hops with it. Chameleon, girgit you have seen. In green areas, in dark areas. That is reptile and it is a colorful animal. It changes its color due to atmospheric changes. Now what is three? Frogs. Frog hop with their back legs. Frog always hop with their back legs. जो पीछे के उसके legs होते हैं उससे frog क्या करती है? Hop करती है. Now what is fourth? Gulmohar plant. It is a name of a plant. Fern like leaves. It has feather like leaves. Sweet potato. Sweet potato. It is not a stem, it is not a fruit, it is not a leaf, it is a root vegetable. You have seen it underground. Okay, now what is sixth one? Creeper. What is a creeper? Weak stem plants. Now this is our last exercise. You have to take a screenshot from here and similar way you have to draw it in your textbook. Okay, you don't need to copy in notebook. Okay student, in this way we have completed the whole exercise of chapter 2. I hope you got it. If you are not understanding any of my points, what you have to do, you just have to take a screenshot students, and later on you have to write it. Okay, so I hope you got it. Thank you so much.